So, did you ever have the first generation iPod Touch?
Yeah, I had the first one.
And do you think the second generation's much better, or do you think
Yeah, it is, because it's one up.
I certainly do own an iPod Touch.
What generation do you have?
I've got the first.
Yes, I do.
iPod Touch?
No, sorry. I've got the Nano.
So let's move on to the iPod Touch. The iPod Touch is an incredible product. We've brought our multi-touch technology and our multi-touch user interface to an iPod. And this is unlike anything in the marketplace. Well, for this holiday season, we're making it even better.
The iPod Touch is Apple's own multimedia device, which premiered to the public in September 2007. Immediately, it was a hit to the broader public, with its multiple functionality of Wi-Fi web browsing, music, video, and photos. Well, we guess you could say it's an all-in-one multimedia experience. But a few months into the life of the iPod Touch, hackers found that they could adapt to the iPod Touch's operating system firmware and adjust and create an even more exciting iPod experience. Jailbreaking was the name given to the process. Now yet, it is so easy to jailbreak an iPod. This is a non-jailbroken iPod Touch 2G. And this is the jailbroken version of the same iPod. As you can see, there is no difference between the two. You are able to customize the themes and tweaks for the iPod, which is not available to non-jailbroken iPod devices. We then asked the public on what they thought of the iPod Touch 2G.
I liked it better than the first generation. That's why I bought it, because it's like the next one up. Kind of thing. It's pretty much the same thing. I don't really see the difference except the name.
Some of the public do disagree on jailbreaking too.
No, it's not, no.
Why haven't you jailbroken it yet?
Because I believe I don't need to actually customize it. I'm really happy with how it came out of the box, and I get full use of its functionality.
With the jailbroken iPod Touch, you can change the layout of the home screen. You can have more apps per page with up to 20 shown on one. You can install any application from the App Store using installers. Now this is for absolutely nothing, regardless if they're paid or free applications.
Will you ever jailbreak your device?
No, I don't have a reason to at this point.
Jailbreaking your iPod Touch is not illegal. You have made an exchange with Apple by paying $400 for one of their iPod devices. This is a fair deal. However, Apple has stated that if the iPod Touch is damaged or unworkable while jailbroken, then Apple refuses to do anything with the problem, mainly due to the customer breaking the warranty on the product. Instead of going through Apple to get a warranty claim, they would have to go through a third-party repairer, which can equate to a costly price. Apple has been scrutinized at for its unfairness towards its customers by the use of its marketing tools. Here we ask whether Apple are trying to steer people into buying applications for their iPods by making customers pay more to use the full experience of the iPod Touch. We asked whether it was unfair for customers to pay $400 for an iPod Touch, then have to fork out more for apps.
In an ideal world, they'd be free, but I think that when you look at the actual price of the apps and what you can actually do with them, I think the price is quite reasonable. When you compare it to, say, a Windows mobile device, where you get applications that aren't as good or as useful, and they're charging upwards to $45 plus.
Your iPod, or do you?
Well, there's a reason they're free. But no, they're not worthy of my iPod.
But do you feel that you need the paid ones, or do the free ones give you enough playtime?
No, the paid ones, like, they're better and stuff.
I believe that the free apps are actually a marketing tool so that you can try it, and then if you like it and you think it's going to be useful, then they give you the opportunity to purchase the full one.
Apple are yet in a pending decision on whether to ban jailbreaking on the iPod Touch. At this point, nothing has been done to halt all operations of jailbreaking, so at this time, it seems okay to have a jailbroken device. You're only risking a warranty from Apple if you choose to have it jailbroken, but on the plus side, you get free apps, themes, tweaks, and much more, which can render the iPod far more advanced than its stock superior. Until Apple makes its decision, it's your choice on what you want to do with your iPod Touch device. Until then, enjoy the fun from your iPod Touch.